Hi everyone. So today we are coming to the next video. That is in reaction mechanism, third part, third step in the reaction mechanism, how the organic reactions are taking place. So in that mainly three steps are involved. First step is what cleavage of the bond, that is what bond fission. We had discussed what type of bond fissions we have. By that bond fission, what type of intermediate compounds we are getting. Based on that stability of intermediate compounds, how many types of reactions are there, we had seen those. Kinetically controlled reaction and thermodynamically controlled reaction. So which is part 1, reaction mechanism. Those who not visit that part 1, you can see in the description of this video. And also part 2 is what we had seen, the types of attacking reagents. So what type of attacking reagents are there? So mainly three types of attacking reagent: free radicals, new electrophilic attacking reagent and nucleophilic attacking reagent. That is what types of attacking reagent. Second part is completed. Now third part, coming to the third part, that is types of electron displacement, which is very very important, which takes a lot of time. So I will make the water simple videos, okay na? So in each and every part of the video is very important part. Okay, so in today's class we are going to see the how many types of electron displacements are there. So after that, so first we'll take the inductive effect. So small introduction and the types of inductive effect we are going to see in this video. So till now, those who not yet subscribed my YouTube channel, you please do subscribe and share with your friends if you really like the content. And also please don't forget to like the video. Okay, so that likes will gives me boosting to do more number of videos. Thank you everyone. Now let's get into the video. That is what the first one, that is types of electron displacement. So it is a third step in the organic reaction. So in that first one will be what, inductive effect, mesomeric effect, hyperconjugative effect. Next is what, inductomeric effect and electromeric effect. So these are the major five types of electron displacement takes place in substrate molecule, that is what, in reactant molecule. Now here, this inductive effect, mesomeric effect, hyperconjugation are what, permanent effect. In absence of attacking reagents also, the electrons will displacement takes place in a substrate molecule. Okay, but whereas this inductomeric effect and electromeric effect are what, these are temporary effects. So in presence of attacking reagent, in presence of suitable reagent only, the electronic displacement takes place. So such type of displacements are said to be what, temporary effects, temporary electronic displacement effect. So permanent electronic displacement effect, in the sense without any reagent, attacking reagent, the electron displacements are taking place. So such type of electron displacements are called what, permanent electronic displacement effect. So in that first one is what, inductive effect. Now first one we are going to see the inductive effect, which is very very important, which is a permanent effect. Now you'll see the what is mean by this inductive effect. It is simply represented as IE. Okay, so inductive effect is nothing but what, the displacement of sigma electron along a covalent bond towards the more electronegative atom is called what, inductive effect. Is the definition is clear to everyone? The displacement of sigma electron along a covalent bond towards the more electronegative atom is called what, inductive effect. Now I am going to take the a simple example here. So it is an hydrocarbon, so which is attached with more electronegative atom. Simply you take the halogen. Halogens are more electronegative atoms in a periodic table. Now you see the halogen family. So it will have the negative charge, more electronegative. So it will have the negative charge. Then what happens, halogen, this bonded pair electrons are attracted by towards itself. Then what happens, whenever it is attracting the bonded pair electron, so this electron of this carbon is transferred towards this halogen atom. So halogen will get the negative charge. This carbon is losing the electron, so this carbon will get the partial positive charge. So then what happens, this carbon is losing the electron, so it becomes weaker. So it want to be stronger. Then what happens? This carbon will withdraw the electron from this carbon. Then what happens? Somewhat partial. When compared to this carbon is having less positive charge. Less positive charge. So very very partial positive charge. So it is what? It is a second carbon. This carbon is attracting the, that is withdrawing the electron towards itself. Okay, now, so then what happens? Positive charge will be further decreases. So when compared to this carbon, what it will do? This carbon will withdraw the electron from this carbon. So then what happens? So it will get the water somewhat very very partial charge. So light charge it will be. So the inductive effect will be there. No, this inductive effect is mainly depends on the distance. That is what this is a first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon. In generally, inductive effect will be disappears after the third carbon. Inductive effect, what happens? It will disappears after the third carbon. Means what? Beyond the third carbon, the ability of attracting the electron will be decreases from the electron withdrawing group. Electronegative atom. Okay, electronegative atom is in the sense what? It is having more ability to attract the bonded pair electron. This called what? Electronegative atom. Now it is attracting the electron from this carbon will attract from this carbon will attract from this carbon. Which is having more positive charge, this first carbon will have the what? More positive charge. Because this first carbon is directly bonded with this electronegative atom. Now you see here, is there any attacking reagents are there in this? There is no attacking reagent. Without attacking reagent, the electrons are displacing towards the more electronegative atom. Through the covalent bond is called what? Inductive effect. Is that clear definition of inductive effect? So inductive effect is what? It is a distance dependent. It is a permanent effect. Now this inductive effects are of two types. Inductive effects are of two types. That is what? Based on the ability of electron accepting and electron donating, we have two types of inductive effect are there. That is what? Positive inductive effect and negative inductive effect. So plus I effect, minus I effect. This plus I effect is also called electron releasing groups. The groups which shows the plus I effect, they are called what? Electron releasing groups. The groups which attract the electron, they are called what? Electron withdrawing groups. So are electron accepting groups. So here electron releasing groups, or it is also called electron donating groups. So it is electron withdrawing group or electron accepting group. Okay, na? Is that clear? So accepting groups, electron donating groups or electron releasing groups. Now what is mean by plus I effect or what is mean by minus I effect? So now we are comparing the what with respect to the hydrogen atom. With respect to the hydrogen atom, the atom or group of atoms which are having a tendency to attract strongly electron, bonded pair electron compared to the hydrogen atom, then they are said to be what? Minus I effect. Which are said to be minus I effect? The atom or group of atom which are having more ability to attract the bonded pair electron compared to that of hydrogen atom is called what? Minus I effect. So which are called plus I effect here? The atom or the group of atom which are having ability to donate the electrons, which are having ability to donate the electron compare more, which is having more ability to donate the electron compared to the hydrogen atom is called what? Plus I effect. Okay, na? So now here we can define the plus I effect in another way also. The atom or group of atom which have less tendency to attract the bonded pair electron compared to the hydrogen, which has more tendency to attract the bonded pair electron. So they are called what? Minus I group. More tendency to attract. Less tendency to attract, that is plus I group. In generally, what are the example for this plus I group? We are going to see. Now plus I group example will be what? In this case, you can take the what? Alkyl groups. That is what? Methyl group. Methyl group is a best example for the what? Plus I group. And also ethyl group C2H5. So, and also you can take propyl group C3H7. So on like that. So what happens as number of alkyl groups are increases, the ability of donating electron will be increases when compared to the hydrogen atom. So these will have the what? More ability to donate the electrons. And not only these, you can take the different types of alkyl groups, that is primary, secondary, tertiary. Now I am going to take the water primary alkyl halide. So sorry, primary alkyl group. This primary alkyl group having less ability when compared to the secondary alkyl group. This is secondary alkyl group. Okay, so it is a secondary alkyl group, and you can take the water which is having further less ability when compared to the tertiary alkyl group. So this tertiary alkyl group is what? More having ability to donate the electron, or which has the what? Less ability to attract the electron. So these are called what? Plus I groups. Generally, plus I groups are what here? Alkyl groups are considered as plus I groups. So how to decide plus I groups? As electronegativity of the atom decreases, plus I effect will be increases. That is what you can take the oxygen family. That is oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. You can take sellurium, will have the what more ability, more plus I effect. After that what sulfur. After that oxygen. Oxygen will have the what least ability to donate the electron, because oxygen is more electronegative. As electronegativity increases, so plus I effect decreases. As electronegativity increases, plus I effect what happens? Decreases. That you do remember. Now you have small question here, so I will explain after minus I effect this one. If you have that ability to decide, so those who watched my videos of hybridization concept, then you can easily do here. So CH triple bond CH is there. So CH2 double bond CH2 is there, and CH3 single bond CH3 is there. That is ethane, ethane is there, which is having more ability to donate the electron. Okay, that is what ethane, after that ethane. What is the reason here? This is very, very important. Based on hybridization concept, based on the percentage of S character, we can decide. Now, what is the hybridization? I will explain here itself only. What is the hybridization of acetylene here? SP. It is also SP. It is also SP. It is what? SP2. It is also SP2. It is SP3. It is SP3. SP3 carbon. So, how I am writing SP hybridization? How I am writing? By seeing the molecule itself only, I am deciding. So, how? So if you watch that hybridization video in organic chemistry, first video, that is first part in hybridization, so you will get the what complete picture. Okay, na? So here what SP hybridization means, percentage of S character is more. More is the percentage of S character. I will write most important point here. So more is the percentage of S character, more is the percentage of S character, more is the electronegativity of atom. More electronegativity of the atom. So then what happens? As the percentage of S character increases, electronegativity of that atom increases. What is the reason? Simply, now you see here, it is a nucleus. So very close to the nucleus, which orbitals will have more penetration power? S orbital will have more penetration power after the PDF. Is it or not? Now, as percentage of S character is increasing, that is S orbital percentage is more. Here SP hybridization in SP, SP2, SP3, S is more, nothing but what? It is a S orbital. So S orbital percentage is increased, which is very close to the nucleus. So then what happens when it is close to the nucleus? So nucleus strongly attract it. So then it will have the what more power to attract the other electrons from the sigma bonded electrons are attracted by the more percentage S character containing carbon atom. That is what more is the percentage of S character, more is its electronegativity. So then what happens? It is very, very important. So based on this, we'll do the what so many number of questions. More is the percentage of S character, more is the electronegativity of that atom. Is that clear, everyone? So next, coming to the what minus I groups. So minus I groups are called what electron withdrawing groups. How we can decide this electron withdrawing nature of the minus I groups here? Minus I groups are nothing but the atom or the group of atoms which are having more ability to attract the sigma bonded electron towards themselves. Compared to the hydrogen, they are called what minus IE groups. minus IE group. These minus IE groups are also called electron withdrawing groups. Now here what happens, if you had seen the water fluorine as electronegativity, as electronegativity increases, electronegativity of atom increases, as electronegativity of atom increases, then ability to withdraw the electron increases. Ability to withdraw the electron, withdraw or attracting, attraction, withdraw or attraction increases. That is minus IE effect increases. Minus IE effect, what happens? Increases as electronegativity of the atom increases. You can take the fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. So here what happens, which one will have more minus IE group? This fluorine. And also you can take the one more example. So different one, that is oxygen, sulfur, so after that cellurium. So you can take like that, because top to bottom what happens, electronegativity decreases. After that you can take the water. Now primary, tertiary, alkyl halide, we are taking. Now which is having more withdrawing nature? This methyl group is having more withdrawing, then after ethyl group, then after withdrawing. It is exactly reverse to the plus I group. Okay, na? So that is, and also you can take the water, you can take the another one, that is acetylene. This is acetylene, will have more electron withdrawing. After that water, ethyne. So after that water, ethane. Because as percentage of S character, you have to explain based on the percentage of S character. It is SP, SP2 hybridized, SP3 hybridized. Here percentage of S character is 50%. Here percentage of S character out of 2 orbital, percentage 2 orbitals are there. So each occupies 50%. Here 3 orbitals are there. Each one will occupy 33.33. That is 33% we are taking. Now here what S percentage will be 25%. Now as percentage of S character increases, electronegativity of the bonded atom increases. When electronegativity increases, minus I effect increases. Is that clear everyone? So we can see the what another one, that is so NF3. So this is NF3 now is having more effect than CF3. Because you see here what bonded atoms are, what here this carbon and here nitrogen is there, which is more electronegative, nitrogen. So both are having same. Similarly what you can take the OH and OR. So which is having more electron withdrawing nature, which is having more minus I group, OH or OR? This OH is having more electron withdrawing. What is the reason? Alkyl group is what? It is an electron releasing group. When it is releases the electron, then what happens? Ability of that oxygen to attract the attraction will be decreases, because it is getting already electron from this alkyl group. Whenever it is getting the electron from this alkyl group, it will be happy. Okay, because already it is getting electron from this alkyl. But whereas here this hydrogen is not having ability to give the electron or take the electron, then what happens? This oxygen try to pull the electron from other. So due to presence of this alkyl group, so this oxygen will have less ability to attract the electron, that is minus IE group. Is that clear everyone? So that is what we can say here. Then here as electronegativity of atom increases, then ability to withdraw the or attraction increases, that is minus IE effect will be increases. Is that clear? Now we'll see the water, some list of order we'll see. So that order is very important. I am going to give now that order. So listen carefully. Yes, see the order of electron withdrawing groups. Order of electron withdrawing group. This order is very important. Now you see here, so the nitrogen with positive charge. This nitrogen with positive charge is what? Electronegative atom with positive charge is highly unstable. So when it will get the positive charge? When it is having sort of electron. That is what it will do then. It is unstable, so it try to neutralize itself by accepting the electron. That is NF3 plus is what? More electron withdrawing among all those. After that NH3 plus, after that N plus R3. So next after that what? Carbon trifluoride. okay, trifluoromethane, so methyl group. Now in this case, what are nitro group, and after that cyano group, after that sulfato group, so sulfonic acid group, after that acyl chloride. It is what? Acyl chloride. Acyl chloride, what happens here? Why it is having more electron withdrawing? Now you see here, this carbonyl carbon is what? It is a sp2 carbon, more electronegative. It is attached with oxygen and as well as electron withdrawing fluorine. Now this is what aldehyde. When compared to aldehyde, so aldehydes and ketones, sorry, so that is acyl carbon. This is what ketone here. You can take the water ketone. You can take the ketone here. So it is not there. Double had written. So now you can take the ketone. Now aldehyde. After that, what we have? Ketone. So after ketone, we have what? Acids. Now you see, among aldehydes and ketone, which is having more ability to attract the electron, this aldehyde. Because in this case of ketone, you see here ketone, both the alkyl groups are there. But whereas here what? Only one alkyl group is there. Alkyl groups are electron releasing groups. Now in this case, acid, RCOOH acid, this oxygen is there as well as this carbonyl carbon is there. So both will withdraw the electrons. Now fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, which we had discussed already, OH and OR. Now you see in case of here, CH, triple bond CH, based on percentage of S character you can decide. So this is what order of electron withdrawing group. Just now I had explained based on percentage of S character. As percentage of S character increases, as percentage of S increases, so then what happens? Then electronegativity of atom increases. Electronegativity of atom increases. Whenever the electronegativity of atom is increased, then what happens? Whenever the electronegativity of atom is increased, then electron withdrawing nature will be increases. That is what negative inductive effect. So next, after this, we'll have the what? Applications of inductive effect. That applications of inductive effect, I will try to divide into three parts, three videos. So which after this video, after this uploading of this video, you will have that application. Applications are very important. There you can decide the which carbocation is stable. So carbon anion is, which carbon anion is stable, free radicals, stability of free radical, stability of carbocation, carbon anion. After that, reactivity of alkyl halide, acidic nature of alcohols, phenols, acids. Those all we are going to discuss there. And basicity of amines, dipole moment, those all we are going to discuss in the applications. So which is very, very nice one, and definitely you will get, you are going to get the what questions from this applications, application part, which is very important. Don't miss. If you really like this video, please do subscribe. Those who not subscribe, those who subscribe, just like, and you make a comment also if you have any doubts. Thank you all of you.